first food event which I'm attending after the COVID pandemic hit us. It still feels strange. And this is at the Mask Lab, and a pop-up's happening here with Guru Marina Balakrishnan, that Thanasari girl, with whom we've become friends, I think, since the COVID pandemic started, and we love her food. So she's doing an Utupura pop-up with sage and saffron, and we're here to support her and eat some great food. This is Marina Balakrishnan. You've been hearing me talk about her and her food quite a bit. This is the first time I've met her. She said, "What's the video going to be about?" I have no idea. But it's lovely meeting you in person.
Same here, Kalyan, because I think it's been like, I think over a year that we've been interacting with each other, and it just feels so good to kind of finally meet.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like we are meeting for the first time.
Absolutely. It's almost like we've known each other for a while.
And it's a very different experience, because till now we've had the Utupura boxes, and it's like a, you know, jigsaw puzzle. You take them all out, and you know, you match it, and you know, put it across the blueprint. Yeah. But to have someone, so we have the sage and saffron and Utupura pop up, which has happened at the Mask Lab. And how was that experience, being a pop up and a collaboration?
I think it's so much fun, because you know, the last 1.5 years being you know, within your home and doing the meal, and then getting out and to meet people in person, to cook hot food, and to really interact with the community, it's like so amazing. And especially with sage and saffron, it's just been great, because we started off with appam and stew class, and it's been progressing, and it's just been going one step to the other. And it's just so wonderful to kind of do things in person. I think we're all missing that. I think that sense of connectivity.
I know, this is the first physical event I've been for.
Yeah.
But I didn't want to miss this, like your first.
Thank you so much, Kalyan, because I think this means a lot to me that you really made that effort to come all the way. And thank you so much.
It was beautiful, because I must say that you know, the presentation had the sage and saffron sensibilities, but the flavors were entirely yours, and right from the beginning with that beze platter, with the pepper hit and the mushroom and the puri, and then you know, the beach court chutney, chichinga is Bengali, and then the pachri, that was so beautiful, and then the rasam which hits you, and it was beautiful. And at the end, that little bread which was in that
kapa roti.
That was
So this whole pop-up has been about getting the lesser known breads. Of course, the parota was there, but you know, we tried to include a lot of the lesser known breads in it.
There's even the dhokla like bread, which is
the vatte appams. Yeah, the vatte appams are there.
A lot of it made with rice.
Most of the Keralite breads are very rice centric. And what is beautiful about it is we kept the tradition, because I wanted to keep the traditional flavors, not play with the recipe. So it's as it is, you know. So it's not like we've kind of tweaked the recipe, made it modern, or it's traditional. It's as it is. It's from my grandmother's kitchen, and just retain that.
I was about to ask you about that, because so much of your food is influenced by your grandmom.
Yeah.
How do you think she would be reacting to this?
Well, I think I'm sure she's, you know, I mean, my grandmother would be, of course, happy, but my mom is like, you know, the Injipuli sorbet. Initially, she was taken aback. She said, "Sorbet, it's an ice cream. Why would you want to do that with an Injipuli? Because Injipuli is served with sandhya."
Yeah.
So then I had to literally explain to her and say, "It's just Injipuli. Same Injipuli has gone into like making something like a sorbet." So I'm really happy with this pop-up, because you know, it's a 5-course meal, and it's been very experimental in the sense of keeping traditional flavors with the sage and saffron scents in it. So it's just been such a win-win for both of us.
This is beautiful. Thank you so much,
Kalyan. Thank you.
And you know, I'm sure your grandma is smiling at all of us.
Thank you. Oh, that was so good.
That's how the menu looks, and I'm very, very excited. The mini Malabar porotas, the karam pori crackers, that's the beetroot pachari, that's the pichinga chutney, lotus crackers, and pepper roast mushrooms. So that's the Malabar mezze. The room's filling up, and the Meze platter was a meal in itself. The, you know, the tangy notes of the patchouli. This pichinga chutney, pichinga is rich gourd in Kerala, so it's like chichinga in Bengali. Was beautiful, the peppery notes of the mushrooms, hot paniyarams, the pori crackers, the Malabar rotis, the Malabar parathas, everything was just beautiful. And now the first course, which is the tomato and Malabar pepper rasam, which is a nice, strong, peppery hit, and with the pungency and tanginess of tomato. And these are chena kappas, so that's kappa. And not potatoes. And there is Marina, who's done all the cooking. We'll talk to her a bit later.
What they have done is a fermented bread. So we ferment the bread and then we steam it. And here what we've done is we've cut it into slices and again the sage and saffron, twist to it with the curry leaves. Actually, Akshat came up with that. Let's do the curry leaves.
And what are the two puris and chutneys? I can see my favorite.
Chamandi. This is chamandi. This
my
is
favorite chamandi puri.
Yeah, you know puri. The chamandi puri. But this is done on the stone.
Okay.
Smoked chilies and coconut.
So how is this puri different from the earlier one, which was on the...
Puri is dry.
Okay.
So you dry roast the coconut and it's not wet. If you see, this one is wet.
Yeah, this almost looks like a...
The puri is always like a dry one where, you know, you can store it for a long time. This you cannot store for a long time.
And this is the...
That's a tomato chutney.
Awesome. Yeah. Thank you.
Question.
This is called the nice patiri taco. So why is it nice?
It's nice because nice is fine.
In Malayali?
Yeah, in Malayalam.
Malayalam.
And anything that is nice, when we say cut it nice, that means cut it fine.
So like finely chopped?
Yeah, finely chopped. So nice patiri is like fine patiri.
So should I change my blog name to nicely chopped?
Finely chopped.
In the middle of a chef's menu is always a sorbet, and this is the inji puli base, which means tamarind and jaggery. So let me have a little change of taste.
Malabar, we have a lot of different breads, but the kakka roti is something which is you don't find so much of it because this is more like a gnocchi.
Yeah, that's what happened.
Yeah,
and is it always served in the curry or you've done that
also? So it's always served in the curry. So the pasta, the kakka roti is put in it and there's a curry. And the curry is always like a rich coconut curry.
Yeah, it was like, it was almost like a meat curry. It was so rich.
I'm glad you said that because that was my intention.
It's almost like a korma sort of. So what's the basis? Coconut?
It's like very slow roasted coconut into like an even brown. And then you put your spices into it. And then there is a texture of, there's texture added with coconut milk. So it's a very rich gravy.
But it's not an overpowering coconut milk. Like it doesn't strike as a coconut milk dish.
So the base is the roasted coconut. The key is getting your coconut right.
And then little potatoes and
the
peas.
Tiny potatoes and it's have to keep it like, how's it, Kalyan?
It's beautiful. It's so satisfying. Like this is the end of the meal. So you sort of get the feeling that.
Yeah. And that was the intention. You wanted something heavy and rich.
Yes.
But yet not overpowering.
No, and with very multiple flavors in it.
Yeah. I'm glad you liked it.
Thank you. What all is in your sundae?
The sundae has achappam.
Yeah.
Rose cookie. Yeah. It's got jackfruit preserve, chakka varati, and the sage and saffron, coconut and chestnut ice cream with lemon jujube. So we kind of got it all together. So when people come every day at my home, we used to cook for 35-40 people. Every single meal we used to have. Because we had a large family. It was like a huge joint family. And then on top of it, my grandfather's people used to come. And so I saw food cooked in abundance, food served like that. So I think that's where it all started coming from.